Get ready to match the stars. Avery Shriver, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Barbara Rose, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Reilly.
Jenny, you know, did you hear Tom Tom?
No, but I heard Fred Fred. She's so quick.
Someone is restless tonight. Are you all right? All right, cool it. Are you all ready?
Yes.
I guess.
All right.
Sure.
Here's the champ. Let's all welcome Anita Kleinert. Hey, Anita.
Anita just has a small amount of money to credit, $100. She won the game, and she's going to try for the big money, over $5,000. You ready for that?
No,
good. We'll do that right after we do this, especially for you.
Are you cold?
Uh-huh.
Oh, here we are. Anita Kleinert will try for the big money.
Right.
Okay, we polled the studio audience, Anita. And we said you write down your best answer to this. Joseph Blank. Now, if you match the answer they gave us most frequently, we give them $500. If you match the answer they gave us second most frequently, you get $250. And then for matching their third most popular answer, you get $100. Three of our six stars will help you.
Richard.
Joseph Cotton.
Joseph Cotton.
A fine actor.
Yes, indeed.
A good little dancer.
Betty.
And a snappy dresser.
I'm one of the ones that will help you by not saying anything. Joseph Stalin.
Joseph Stalin. Oh, I knew him. He lived in our block for a while.
A good dancer.
Yeah. Oh, good dancer, snappy dresser, and a peachy kid.
Charles.
Joseph DiMaggio.
Joe DiMaggio.
A good dancer.
That's right, a snappy dresser. And a 400 lifetime hitter. No. Now, you got Joe DiMaggio, Joe Cotton, and Joe Stalin. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own Joes. Have you got a better Joe in mind?
No, I thought of Joseph Cotton.
You thought of Joseph Cotton.
Good actor, really.
Okay.
So was Joseph Stalin.
Joseph Cotton, none of friends to be forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland, go. May we see the $100 response. Stalin, I told you he was hanging around. Everybody thinks he's dead. Ha. Okay. Let's see if Joseph Cotton is hiding under the $250 response. Yes, he is indeed. You got Joe Cotton. All right, now what do you think is going to be under the big ones, stars?
Joseph and Mary.
Joseph of Nazareth.
Joseph and Mary. Yeah.
Kennedy.
What?
Kennedy.
Kennedy.
Mankiewicz.
Mankiewicz. No.
Slide it. Joseph and Mary.
Joseph and Mary. You were right.
Same okay. Family as Mankiewicz.
Fund me.
Now, Anita, you will be playing for $2,500 to collect. You got to match a celebrity exactly.
Okay, Richard.
Okay, Richard. You're okay, Richard.
Okay, thank you.
All right, hang around over here, face me. And this is it. Worth $2,500 to this little lady if she does indeed match Richard. Random blank. R-A-N-D-O-M blank. Now, he's made up his mind, Anita. We ask you to make up your mind. Give us the answer that he's written on the card. We give you $2,500. Random blank.
House.
Well, if you do match him, you will harvest a lot of money.
But then again, it's your choice.
Random choice, yes.
Randolph Scott. Well, the list goes on. And the list goes high.
$2,850. Congratulations to you. We're very happy for you.
Listen, Anita, we'll give you a chance to catch your breath while we introduce a new player. Here comes Jim Dunn. Jim Dunn. Jim Dunn. Oh, there he is. Stop. Away you go. Jim, you know Anita?
I sure do.
Yes, she's very happy at this moment because she gets $2,850 to her
credit.
Fantastic. And we welcome you, sir, and ask you to tell us about yourself, if you would, please.
I'm...
Thank you. Okay, now, let's go on.
I don't know now.
Now, where are you from? Quick, now,
what Albany, Georgia.
Oh, now you tell us. Yeah. Albany, Georgia.
A big city east of Plains. And I'm a farmer there.
Really? What do you farm?
Believe peanuts.
Peanuts.
Really?
Is peanuts in the fruit or vegetable family?
Vegetable.
Vegetable.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And do the little peanuts hang on a vine or do they grow under the ground?
Under the ground.
So it's a root plant.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Right.
Is it a good business?
Off and on. We had the drought, too.
Oh, that's too bad.
So really, yeah.
Dried peanuts.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Really dry.
Are all peanut farmers snappy dressers like you?
This is all borrowed.
All borrowed?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
We wear blue jeans.
Blue jeans?
Uh-huh.
That's what you wear.
Yeah.
Okay, Jim, pleasure to meet you. Have you here. Good luck to you. We'll start this game right after we do a commercial about peanut butter. We are ready. Here we go. Jim, it's up to you to choose A or B.
May I try A, please?
A. Any special significance to that?
Comes first.
Count Dracula said, "Boy, is my wife the dumb. Last night you put blank on my wooden stake. My wife is dumb. Last night you put blank on my wooden stake.
Oh, I got it. Oh, I got it. Oh, I got it.
Very good.
Learn to think things through.
Smart. Hello, Jim.
I'm all ready.
Count Dracula said, "Boy, is my wife dumb? Last night she put blank on my wooden stake."
Blood.
Blood. They don't like you.
No.
But I like you. What do you say, Avery?
Oh, boy.
Barbecue sauce.
Barbecue sauce. A little play of words there, Jim. See my wooden steak? Barbecue sauce?
I don't care whether they like you, Jim. I'm crazy about you. And I think you're cute and adorable, but I didn't match you. I said ketchup.
Ketchup is good. Barbecue sauce, all that stuff. Chuck?
I think we need some onions.
Onions for the steak and onions? Working up a little appetite here, Jim. But so
Hamburger.
Far, no blood. Barbara?
The old A1 sauce.
A1 sauce. Very good on the steak,
Thank
especially.
You.
This is very bad on the steak.
Very bad. The ketchup kills the flavor.
Plain ketchup all day.
What do you say, lady in red?
More Wolfbane von Helsing ketchup.
Okay. So, Jim, now you got the hang of it.
Uh-huh.
You'll really get rolling. Later. I think. Nick said, "My wife has the world's worst sense of direction. Today she got lost in the blank." My wife has the world's worst sense of direction. Today she got lost in the blank. Splendid. Finished. Wife has the world's worst sense of direction. Today she got lost in the blank. Make a funny noise. Okay, Anita. Nick said, "My wife has the world's worst sense of direction. Today she got lost in the blank."
Bathroom?
Bathroom. I didn't think of that one.
No.
I thought of another room in the house. What did you say?
Yeah, I got her into the car at least, in the garage.
In the garage. Driving around the garage, got lost. Yeah, very good. Brett?
Oh, I got her all the way downtown, dear. I said she got lost in the supermarket.
That is a good response, too. Charles?
That was a Maine accent for you people who are studying fine accents of our country.
Kitchen.
Kitchen is a good one. All right, Barbara Rose, we come to you. My wife has the world's worst sense of direction today. She got lost in the...
Kitchen.
Kitchen.
Like
good.
Charles.
Yes. Yes, sir, Richard?
Call me John.
Ooh. John! That's one for her. Now, madam.
You've been listening to idle rumors again.
No.
She could have gotten lost in the Wayne. John Wayne.
John! That's two for you. Now let's go to round two. Jim, again, A or B?
I didn't do so well with A. Let's try B.
B it is? You got it. Everyone will play. Sally said it's been raining for 40 days and 40 nights.
Ooh.
Everything in the park is so wet, even the blanks are wrinkled. Raining 40 days, 40 nights. Everything in the park is so wet, even the blanks are wrinkled.
The blanks.
The blanks.
Plural.
Rhyme. 40 days and 40 nights. Even the blanks are wrinkled.
Now I'm really going to try and think this one through.
Jim is hoping you're going to think it through, too.
Hang in, Jim. We're gonna get it this time.
Yes, of course. Rain 40 days, 40 nights. Everything is so wet.
I see it.
In the park. Even the blanks are wrinkled. Sally said it's been raining for 40 days and 40 nights. Everything in the park is so wet, even the blanks are wrinkled.
Trees?
Even the trees are wrinkled. Now, we did say park, and the first thing that occurred to him about being in a park were the trees.
Of course.
But there are other things in parks.
Dogs.
Dogs.
That love trees.
Right.
But they don't wrinkle. Muggers.
Muggers are wrinkled. They hang around in the park, Brett?
This may be a match because it's very close to trees. And it's on them. It's like bark. Even the leaves are wrinkled.
The leaves are wrinkled. They're thinking about it. They decided against it. Now, Charles.
I don't like them.
Keeping in the swing of these totally boring answers, squirrels.
Squirrels is a good answer. Ever seen a wrinkled squirrel? Oh, it's a terrible sight. Barbara?
Yes.
Jim is looking for trees.
Well, another real zippy answer, benches.
Even the benches are wrinkled. Now, Jim, here's the way it is. You got to match Richard and Betty to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
Mm-hmm. 40 days and 40 nights.
Even the statues.
Even the statues. What do you have, Betty? Squirrels. So that means Anita wins again. Jim, it was a pleasure to meet you. Good luck with your peanut farming endeavor. And
thank you.
We'll send some gifts for you that'll help guide you through the next drought.
Okay.
So long, Jim. We'll spin him off and spin a message or two for you. Hurry back.
Today's consolation prizes are first, St. Mary's crisp, easy pair of sheets and pillowcases in handsome traditional patterns and soft, pretty colors to complement any decor. And Franciscan Sea Sculptures dinnerware, timeless beauty and durability with the fragile look of China. Six patterns in sand and white, Sea Sculptures by Franciscan. And a crock pot and a supply of summer-style dinner fixings from Red and White Foods. Red and White Foods, the quality brands for nutritious economy and delightful dining. And a radio and a supply of Tootsie Roll candies. Take your change the Tootsie way. Tootsie Pop Drops, Tootsie Pops, and Tootsie Rolls, a new style candy jar. Another round of fun now with Gene Raven.
Okay, Johnny O. Now here we go again with Anita Kleinert. She has $2,950. Has won her second game. We'll try for the $5,000 number again. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. We polled the studio audience, Anita, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Hall blank. Hall blank. Okay? Wait a minute. I just want to remind you, you'll get $500 if you match your most popular answer. For matching the second most popular, you get $250. And for matching the third, $100. And three of our six stars will really give you some really, really good advice.
Richard.
Hall of Fame.
Hall of Fame.
Barbara.
How about Hallmark?
Nice Hallmark.
Cards. Yeah. Yes.
Brett.
Hello,
just
Brett.
A minute.
Third is tough. She'll think of one.
Hall of Monty. What the hell is that?
No. No. No.
Hall Closet.
Hall.
Closet.
Closet.
Closet. Okay. Hall Closet, Hallmark, and Hall of Fame.
Hallway, Hall.
Those are the three. You want one of those or you want to give us one of your own?
I think I'll go Hall of Fame.
Okay. Let's find out if it's up there and if so where. We'll begin at the bottom and we'll reveal a $100 response. Hallmark is up there, Barbara's answer. May we see Hall of Fame if it's under the $250 number? Hallway. All right. Last chance for Hall of Fame. Slide it. Attaboy. You pick up another $500. You're up to $3,450 now. Now you're going to play for the big one, the $5,000 number. And you have to match one, remember.
Richard.
Okay, Richard, here we go. That's it. Good luck to you. Anita, listen carefully now. Think carefully before you respond. Range blank. That's R-A-N-G-E blank. Range blank. Anita, give us the answer that Richard has written on the card. We give you $5,000. Range blank.
War.
Range war.
W-A-R.
Okay, range war is your answer. Richard, she says that'll match you for the $5,000.
A range finder.
Range finder. Yeah. Range finder. Okay, Anita, you're doing pretty well. You got $3,450, and you're going to meet another player now. You ready to do that? Let's all welcome Diane Mead. Here she comes. Hello, Diane. Okay. How are you, Diane?
Just fine, thank you.
Well, good. Where are you from?
I'm from Los Angeles.
Yeah.
I'm a graduate of UCLA, and I'm married.
Yeah.
And I teach first grade.
No kidding.
Yeah.
I bet those kids love you.
Well, they're pretty special. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you went to a good school, and you've got a marvelous personality. You're a handsome woman, and I hope you're a good game player, because she's pretty good. You may have A or B.
A.
A. Are you ready for this? Here we go. Joe said, I played the world's toughest golf course. Instead of sand traps, the course had blank traps. Instead of sand traps, a very tough golf course, very difficult. Tough as it. Instead of sand traps, the course had blank traps.
Yes, they did.
Blank traps.
Yeah, what are those things? Time. Come up here, hon. Oh, I love you so much. I just want to give you a hug. Yeah, that's it. Gotcha. You're a wonderful person.
Her memory needs refreshing occasionally, every 20 minutes. Okay, Diane. Joe said I played the world's toughest golf course. Instead of sand traps, the course had blank traps.
Mouse traps.
Mouse traps. That would not make it difficult. Mouse traps wouldn't make it tough, would it, Avery?
Not with my feet. No, bear traps.
Bear traps would make it really difficult. Brett?
Don't anybody take offense. Booby traps.
Booby traps. Yes. No. Those are like a small minefield or booby traps. What do you say?
Pebble traps.
That stinks! No.
Yes.
Thank you. I worked on construction years ago. It's true it was only one day, but I had to shovel stones and pebbles, and there's nothing harder to do.
What has that got to do with playing golf?
Sand? Pebbles are bigger
good,
sand?
Good, Barbara. This girl's right. Getting it. Good.
All right. I don't want
okay,
it.
Okay, Rocky.
Okay, Barbara. A difficult golf course. Instead of sand traps, of course, had...
Well, Charles and I think similarly. Cement traps.
Right. Cement traps.
These chicks know what's going on.
You tell them, Chuck.
You were in construction, weren't you?
I am still in construction.
You're very well constructed from where I sit. I said bear, darling.
Bear. Bear traps, very good. What do you say there?
We may have to have a meeting.
Okay.
Because
your house or mine?
Well, I said animal traps. Now it's
aha. The meeting's over.
Couldn't we just have a short meeting and then
decide? No, sorry, the meeting's over. Meeting's adjourned until the next time. So there you are, no score in the middle of round one, and we've got a message or two just for you. Here we go. Goodbye.
Here you go, goodbye.
That's it. No, we've got a second or two to look for Barbara Rhodes in Doc Simon's show.
The Goodbye Girl.
Goodbye Girl.
Don't forget Betty, what's her name?
Oh, yes, look for Betty White.
What's your name, Burnett Show?
On the Carol Burnett Show on CBS. Don't forget to see that, you lady.
Thank you, Gino.
Next time
don't
you get together,
him,
you
thank
should
me.
Really
thank
look
you,
for these people. Don't
these people.
Agree?
Watch for these people right now.
All right.
Nipsey Russell, Rex Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Susie Sullivan, Richard Dawson, and Marsha Wallace.
I'm Gene Raver. Join us next time. Match game 78. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
78 for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.